Hello and welcome. We're Secret Agent Agency. My name is Kevin, and I've been training for the day that I must defend myself against the Wazzler. And joining me is Jihun. Are you out there, Jihun?
Yeah, and I never played a power, so don't sue me, Nintendo.
And Andrew is also here. Say hi.
Hi. How's it going?
And this is our last stream of this game for sure, but it might even be our last like recording. We'll see. I don't want to put that evil into the air, but of Virtue's Last Reward, Zero Escape Virtue's Last Reward. I'm really excited to get down into it, but first I want to put it off just a little bit longer and ask you guys if you have anything you want to talk about before we begin.
Like on not game related.
Well, yeah, sure, and then we can go into your game-related thing.
Oh, okay. Oh, man, everything with as far as current event of, like, the week, I don't know how much, like, that's playing in, for you in North Carolina, but everything with that guy is amazing. I don't know if you were, like, that guy is a hell of a poster.
Yeah. Post, man. I will let you know that I've been keeping up with it, but the content of the story of Mr. Robinson, right, is his last name.
Yeah.
Has been the content of the story is maybe something we don't want to begin our video with. If it's going to go on YouTube, it's probably going to demonetize it if we, or you know, like get us I don't know, put into a hole.
It's just so funny, like that got dropped, like the very last opportunity for him to drop out, and he's like, fuck that, I'm not.
If I had those like those self-censoring machine, the one that makes a beep noise, I'd be playing this shit all the time talking about the topic. Oh yeah, but that guy, he said this beep and he said beep like that.
yeah there's basically nothing of substance that we can actually talk about with it that, you know, aren't gonna fuck over this video on YouTube.
Oh yeah.
So I think we're just going to not, but to kind of dance around the topic, what exactly is he running for? Because I've seen signs everywhere, but it's just like this guy for governor. A government position. Governor? Okay. Yeah. There's this guy running for a governor in North Carolina, and he's said some incredibly vile stuff on a porn website.
And what makes it even crazier, he's a person of a color, and he says something that's against his people, basically. I'm like, mm-hmm. Wow, dude, he's, really?
He's also really into a particular group of people that he is litigating against.
So basically, if you ever watch a cartoon series called Boondocks, and there's a character named Uncle Ruckus, that's basically him.
Mm-hmm.
That's only the latest stuff from like this week. He's like got a history.
He's got a history of some terrible stuff. So you guys ever just wonder if we are doomed to just inch ever closer to the election without ever actually reaching it?
I mean, this election is ever since the you-know-who's appearance, like, it's been, things have been crazy. Like, what, there was even those news about how some sheriff is basically like telling people to write down the address or like write down the
name. Yeah, pretty much that was in.
Yeah, the OIO. Like, write down the names and address of the people who put the campaign sign for the one party. Wait. And
you know what I just realized, guys? The whole Haitian immigrants are eating cats and dogs in Ohio thing happened after our last stream.
Yeah, that's like ever since the debate. It's just been nonstop.
Yeah.
Even advance, like, say, like, yeah, made it up, whatever.
I mean, I posted on our event of the week channel, but, like, yeah, the person who started all was like, oh, I didn't mean to explode like that. I'm sorry. Bitch, you're only saying sorry because you got exposed. You were fine with spreading that shit with your racist friend.
So I've been playing a lot of Marvel vs. Capcom 2 over the past couple weeks.
Oh, you've been taking it for a ride?
I've been going for a ride. The game is beautiful. One thing that I really like, and they didn't have to do this, but they did, and I really like it, is the variety of like CRT filters. Like they have different, they have different kinds of pixel masks for like an arcade monitor versus like a home monitor. Like they have like the triads and like it, like there's all these like different like CRT filters to make the game look extra nice. Cause Marvel vs. Capcom 2, they didn't really care too much about how the game looked. Like from like a pixel art quality standpoint, things are kind of stretched and squished, and because they were basically figuring, because the stages are a 3D space, and they were kind of trying for the first time to figure out how to put sprites onto surfaces, basically on a 3D plane, to make Marvel vs. Capcom 2. And so there's like weird stuff with the edges happening. So I think having like a filter over it is probably a good call. It hides a lot of that stuff. My team back in the day was Cable and kind of just like a insert second character here depending on matchup, and Sentinel. And I don't know, that feels like really meta, and I just like kind of want to mess around with other characters. So I've been doing like the BB Hood and Juggernaut shell, the trying out Tron Bonn in different teams, and I saw some videos of a Rogue and a Sabretooth combo that looks fun, so I've been messing around with them. I haven't fought Wesler yet, but I am on the hunt.
Okay.
And by Wesler, of course, I mean seven-time world champion Justin Wong. He's been terrorizing people who are playing the game for their first time.
Maybe you can finally have your shot at fighting against him.
Yeah. I fought against some pretty high-level people in Street Fighter 4. That was cool. I fought against Gutex and Mike Ross. I'm trying to remember his name. PR Balrog. L.I. Joe. Like, I fought a bunch of them online. I lost against all of them, but, you know, good times.
So, step it up. Capcom vs. Marvel 2 has re-released, maybe, compared to your old days and nowadays. Have your main has been changed?
Oh, like, has like, the actual game been changed?
For you, no, for you particularly, has your main been changed?
I would say yes. I'm out of shape in the game. And also, my hands aren't what they used to be. I have the hands of like a good like grandfather now. My hands are like I don't know, like 200-year-old hands, and the rest of my body is like the body of an 80-year-old person. I'm not like the spry youngster I used to be when it comes to a game that operates that quickly. I don't have the reaction time. My hands feel stiff and kind of sore after I play it. It's a lot of mashing.
Damn, Boomer.
I know. It makes me feel like a fucking old man. I'm turning to dust. I don't have the fortitude that it takes to be good at Marvel 2 anymore. But damn it, I am having fun.
So what's your main now compared to your younger days?
Oh, I've still just been like trying out different teams. As I said, I've been looking at BB Hood and Juggernaut, and my third has kind of moved around between Tron Bon, Zangief, Captain Commando, people like that. Zangief and Tron Bon together are really funny also. Because he has like a belly flop attack that he has like super armor from, so you can like put in the Tron Bon assist that hits awkwardly plus the super armor thing, and you just like you just have this wall of hurt. Good times. This is probably like really bad TV to talk about, but also I've started up a game of Persona 5 again. I'm gonna really try to stick with it this time.
I wanna play
Royal. Yeah, Royal, yeah.
So I'm gonna interrupt you, Jihun, with the Royale. I played through, got all the way to like the added content on PS4, and just fucking dropped it. And then I got the PC version. And I made it to the space dungeon, and just could not. I don't know. It's something about that game. Whereas like Reload really sucked me in. It was kind of fun coming back to that after so long.
Interesting.
I had a lot more fun with Reload, I feel, than I did Royale.
Yeah, that's the thing. When I play 3 and 4, I get sucked in. I played 4 multiple times. Like, I've been holding myself off of playing Reload because, damn it, I told myself I'd finish 5 before I went back to 3. Right? Because I have this game I haven't experienced versus this game I've kind of experienced. But the world and characters of 3 and 4 just, like, suck me in. Whereas 5, like, I don't know what it is. Like, I should love it. Like, everybody's a goth kid. You know,
it looks,
you got
great.
Like the black and red color scheme. It's so stylish, but yes. I bounced off of it so hard every time I tried to play it.
Now I'm really curious now that you guys are saying, like, what exactly is about those two that sucked you in so bad, and yet Fob is not? I just don't know.
I think it's the characters. I think I like the characters a lot more in those games, especially 4. I think that's my favorite cast.
Oh, yeah, definitely top 4. Gang. Yeah.
4 has definitely got the best cast.
GA's my BFF.
GA's cool. I like 3's like overall aesthetic. Yes. And like, honestly, the randomly generated dungeon, I'm cool with that.
Mm-hmm.
Over the set pieces were nice, but it got like, I don't know, it became just like a fucking chore towards the end in 5.
Interesting.
Okay. But Persona related, how interested are you guys in Metaphor?
I'm gonna play it, but
I need to watch some gameplay video because I'm kind of been on the fence. So.
I'm interested.
Yeah, I'm gonna play it, but I'm totally in the dark. That's one of the games that you know me. It's like I don't need to watch trailers or anything. I know I'm gonna play it, so I just like I'm totally in the dark.
So a little bit of rolling backs. This content might just come. My comment on Persona 5 Royal is like I want to play the game on PS5 so bad, or at least better computer, because I played Royal. Did I play Royal on PS4? I forget. But like, yeah, I played Royal on PC. My PC, the one that Andrew got me because my previous one broke, could not handle Persona 5 Royal's graphic. It actually chugs.
Mm-hmm.
So imagine how jealous I am when I see those streamers playing the Persona 5 Royal on the highest setting. Graphical setting, and then it's just smooth, running smooth as butter. I'm like, God, that FPS, that sweet FPS. And I cannot experience that ever now that fucking PS5 is like ridiculously expensive. And then, I build another PC, but I don't have energy to do so. I just don't have energy to search for parts and all that. I'm just saying, and also, like, I don't mind putting it together, I'm just afraid of, like, finding out, oh shit, something went bad and I have to do some research and fix it and like maybe possibly return it. It wouldn't, and then I was kind of talking about this topic a little bit with Andrew before the stream, but yeah, if there's a micro center in my area and I can just, even if it's slightly more expensive than Amazon or Newegg, the fact that I can just go there and return it would be so fucking sweet, you know? That would definitely change things.
I don't know what to say when people say that, because like to me, like building computers and messing with hardware, like that's the good stuff, man. That's fun. I would I kind of build computers just as like a hobby. Like I just enjoy doing it. I like looking up like, you know, what parts go together well and what like aesthetically looks nice, because that's like a thing you can do.
I guess for me, it's something that I wanted to be stress free. Per region is, you know, because you want this, because you're making a, or at least for nowadays, like you're making a shit ton of money, so like, so you have a good time for a long time, you know. That's why you. Mm-hmm. That's why in my head, I want this to be stress free as much as possible.
You just want someone else to build it.
And I don't know. I see so many horror stories about like pre-builts having like the fucking please remove this before assembling sticker on the CPU cooler and stuff like that. Like the amount of that kind of video that I've seen from like pre-built computers is just like, I don't think you're really doing too much better with a pre-built. Like it's like you could make the mistake or you could pay somebody else the money to make the mistake for you, I guess, is what it comes down to. I feel like quality assurance everywhere is just like in the shitter.
Yeah, I mean, why I posted that one on the new X RMA was being questionable by Gamer Nexus. I don't know. Were you aware of it when it was happening?
I used to be a huge Newegg fan, and now I've been avoiding them for the past dozen or so years. I have not bought anything from Newegg in a while because I had a bad RMA experience.
Yeah, which is what the Gamer Nexus was discussing.
Mm-hmm.
And then that's why I'm like, that's another downside. Like, if I have a trustworthy retail as well, like I can buy stuff and like something wrong, I return it. I think I'd be less stressful about this, but because like the fact that I have to like fight for the item to return because like something went wrong, whether it's a manufacturer or delivery, you know, that's the part. Oh, fuck, I don't want to deal with this. I'm just too tired to deal with it right now, at least for me. No, because it's definitely not a near future, but it's a potential, but a possibility. But like, once the change in my job happens, maybe I'll have more time for me to spare, and by then maybe I'll be more fine with like tinkering with some mm-hmm. parts, all that kind of stuff, returning and all that. Could be. So we'll see.
So, Andrew, I think we're getting back into game talk. Oh. You had something you wanted to share.
Okay, so this is going to be likely our final stream of this game. We're going to see what I presume will be the last endings. And so I kind of was doing like a review. I've already like been kind of reviewing the episodes after the fact. And I got little summaries I wrote up from each ending in the order that we unlocked them, which may or may not have been like the optimal viewing experience. I don't know, that's what we perceived in the game. So from the top, we first encountered the Dio ending, because I think we more or less worked from left to right. We hit locks here and there, and we kind of wanted to finish every non-locked thing first before going back and hitting the locks. We usually went with to not betray, to ally first and then betray.
Mm-hmm.
So we saw the Dio ending first from doing that. And that gave us a lot of information. So I'll just kind of like summarize each ending and kind of go through that. We can chat about it. So from Dio's ending, that's the only ending we actually left the facility.
Yes.
We learned that he was an agent of the Myrmidons, which is related to Free the Soul, a terrorist organization looking to possibly destroy the world. Anyone infected with Radical Six looks to kill themselves or free their soul. The founder's named Brother, looking to create a new form of human through cloning. Brother was born into a poor family, didn't know his father, lost his mother at an early age. His only family was his younger brother left. Brother was an Esper. When Brother was 16, Left was found dead by way of possible suicide, but was actually killed. He then started Free the Soul at age 26, researched human cloning, abducted a team of scientists from the USA, And then from there created many clones, all based off of left Dio's from the fourth generation. And we know that Dio's mission was to infiltrate the facility. The fact that he quote unquote succeeded in his ending presumably was placing and arming the bombs. Anything else on his ending? Not really. There was apparently a shelter nearby, and that's where we were kind of heading off to on that ending. Any other input on Dio's ending?
Dio revealed the code for one of the mini bombs.
Yes, so that was where we got the number zero bomb, and Fi was the one who confronted him over that.
Yeah, the funny thing was, at that point, as we were playing, we hadn't heard about any bombs yet.
No, those are all on the extreme right side of the timeline mm-hmm. tree. We were all the way on the left.
Mm-hmm.
Bombs only seem to be relevant on the far right. Dead old lady on the far left. And the middle just kind of be, it's like, kind of all over the place, I suppose. So the next one we saw was Clover's ending. From that, we learned that she and Alice are agents of SOIS, Special Office of Internal Security under the DOD. She met Alice right after 999 ended, after they escaped the ship. They got separated from Oi and Akane. They never located them. I think they were in separate vehicles at the end of 999. So Clover and her brother, as well as many other kids from the first Nonary game, all get recruited by Alice. They learn that the terrorist organization are preparing to unleash a worldwide viral pandemic. They assembled the Espers to access the morphogenic field. And she wasn't convinced until Seven, who was the cop who saved all the kids in the first Nonary game and was one of the players in the 999 Nonary game. He convinced her to join. Their first mission was to infiltrate a research facility, but she got captured. And shortly after that, they learned where their headquarters were, going to strike on December 25th, 2028, but then they got snatched by someone in a mask on the 22nd. And that was kind of the rest of that. I think everyone committed suicide at the ending for her, at the very end of her ending.
Yep.
Next one was Kay's ending. And we learned most of Kay's backstory before we got to his ending, because that had a lock. And then, like, his backstory, we were finding out he's a quote-unquote backup for his father. He was raised from an early age in some kind of facility. We're presuming it's this one that we're in here. He had a robot lady as a caretaker. We're pretty sure that's Luna. Later met an old woman that we are pretty much convinced was Akane. And that she was going to die for the work that she and his father were working towards. He shared one of the keys accessing the computer in his ending, and when we unmasked him, we found out that he is us. And, like, we were making lots of guesses here and there. We're pretty certain that we're the old man who is working with Akane, so he's our backup.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else on Kay? I like that reveal. Like, I think you made every call as the things were coming up.
Yeah, if you rewatch the stream. Yeah, if you rewatch the stream, like, Kevin was so happy with the fact that every guess he made was correct on the spot.
So the next one we got was Alice ending. And that one kind of added more to what we learned from Clover. We know that Alice, so her father is Egyptian, her mother French. Her father was a scientist involved with cloning. He worked in an American lab, and on her ninth birthday, she found that he had been kidnapped by terrorists. Presumably, free the soul, Myrmidons. Alice is a genius from a young age, got an internship and eventually hired by the DOD. She comes to learn that the terrorist organization is the Myrmidons. Commander is named Left, and they know his age and gender, but nothing else. They're associated with Free the Soul, the by my brother, blah, blah, blah. We already heard this from other endings. She makes her way to the location of the second Nonary game, 999. Looking for the Myrmidons, Gintaro Hanjo. So he was Ace in 999. He was the one behind the original Nonary games. And Aoi and Akane got him involved in that situation to kind of get revenge on him and the others in the original Nonary game. Supposedly, he's involved with Free the Soul. She found her father's corpse at the facility where they recovered Clover, and on his corpse, he had left behind the coordinates of their headquarters. A chemical factory disguised as an abandoned building. But then, once again, she got kidnapped right alongside Clover by a man in a mask. The next ending was Sigma's ending. And we were initially thinking it was going to be a Luna ending, because we were getting like lots of little bits with Luna as we were chatting with her.
Was this where we found out that she was a robot?
No.
It was. This is where we found out we were part robot.
Yes, she gave us the second password on that computer that led to the Luna ending. Mm. Her and Kay.
And then, like, in that ending alone, like, there's a lot of hinting, like, why is Luna like this? Like, it's as if she's not a human or those kind of, something along the line.
Well, so our conversation with her in this ending, right before it ended, was like, the laws of robotics, are we part robot? Because that was where we were bleeding white blood from our hand. We reveal Dio to everyone, like in this confrontation, we're like on it, all over him. But as what happens in another ending, he gets separated from his detonator or whatever, and then yes. Triggers like a 30-minute countdown.
One of the failsafe system.
So Luna examines us with Adam, and then it's like, oh, we have robotic arms. The next one was the Luna ending, far to the left, because we had the passwords, we went for it. She's a robot. Dun-dun. Aluminum foil can fail the, or ruin the armbands. You can just take them right off with aluminum foil. It's amazing. Confirmed that Akane's the old woman. She was having a conversation with Luna, that she's meant to die by Dio so that he could be a part of the game. Luna could always disobey her orders, but she chose not to. And that's like...
Well, apparently she would, like, crumble to dust if she disobeyed her orders, and that happened.
No, because she was crumbling to dust because of the... she was stabbed with one of the medicine that actually... acted as a muscle relaxant, but also that also... By doing so, that also...
It messed up her artificial skin.
Correct.
She also called us doctor if she fell apart.
Right.
The next ending was Tenmyoji ending, which we thought was going to be Quark ending.
Yeah, I feel like Quark and Tenmyoji should have been flip-flopped.
So my notes here were Ijunpei and parallelograms are tough. We spent forever on that rotating block puzzle. We had a chat with Zero. It was a hologram recording. He compared our situation to termite mounds, us blindly building towards something greater than ourselves. We also learned that Quark can write in such a way as to leave a novel behind on a single sheet of paper. Jibe found him and raised him. Quark seemingly incredibly lucky, surviving despite numerous close calls throughout his life. And Jibe cares about him a lot. That's what we learned on that ending. Next one was the Quark ending. Like, that's the last ending we've seen just before what we're about to do.
And he likes root beer.
We learned that in the Tenmyoji ending.
Oh.
On the Quark ending, we lost an arm grabbing Dio as he escaped alongside Kay. Quark got the old lady's ID, and we got a password from that. I assume, like, so we know all four shutdown codes for the bombs. So Akane's password is probably going to be relevant for whatever is after that, is my presumption. Because that's like all we have left that we've learned in other endings to utilize. So in Fi's ending, I'm presuming that's what we're building towards, we had that extended conversation in the library, I think it was, about multiple universes, Schrodinger's box. Well, who's to say that the world itself actually isn't in the, you know, the world is in the box, and our job is to open the box and see what happens. Like, the world is going to change when we leave. It's kind of the way that I was interpreting that
conversation. You know what they say about the life. Life is like a box of chocolate.
And this is also the ending route where we got our hands on the device that lets us interface with the bombs. And we've located, I think, at least two of the bombs, right? One's in the garden, one's in the room where Alice committed suicide in, like, almost every run.
The cruise quarter, yeah.
Yes, everyone is alive. Most other endings, usually someone's dead, usually Alice. But this is one of the few where everyone is still alive, no one's escaped yet, and I think we have the one more puzzle to do that we're going to probably have to do shortly. So there you go. There's my summary.
Yeah,
you picked up on a lot of details that I just missed. I feel like I'm really good at, like, just picking up vibes of things, and that has carried me to make predictions and stuff.
Right.
Yeah. Like, I'm good at just, like, picking up vibes and, like, narrative structures and stuff like that, but you picked up a lot of details that I missed.
Well, anyway, make sure you get your hydrate ready, because you're going to need a lot of lines, Kevin.
Yeah, probably got, like, two drinks at least.
Yeah, I actually kind of finished my beer, but I still have water. You guys think I should start here?
No.
Okay. That was, let's go right here. Who planted the bomb?
Let's do it. You ended with the Ace Attorney moment.
Yeah, we're not skipping anything at this point.
Wait. Huh? You only need to search one person.
What? Why?
Because I figured out who did it. I know who did it. The words were out of my mouth before I'd even realized I was saying them.
How can you... There's no way.
Yeah. I met Fi's gaze and nodded, and then turned away. I know who set the bombs. That person... Kono Dio da! That person is you, Dio.
Dio. Objection.
Come on, what is this? Are you high?
Achievement unlocked. Who set up us the bomb? Part A. Come on. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, we're about to find out. Sorry, Kay, but could you hold him down? It's on him, I promise.
Knock it off, Sigma. You're doing this all backwards.
So? This isn't a court. Besides, all we want is to know who set the bombs. And why are you getting so worked up anyway? If you're innocent, then asserts will show that, and I'll look like an idiot.
Nice try, but that's some bullshit totalitarian logic. I don't think so. What are you even basing this on? How do you know I set the bombs?
Because...
Spit it out!
I know about the Myrmidons.
The Myrmidon? What? I beg your pardon?
No! How do you know that, Sigma?
Oh, that's not all I know. I know about Free the Soul, and I know about Brother.
What the hell are you talking about?
I can tell you the details later. But there's no question that you were the one who set up the bombs.
The fuck do you think you are? None of that has anything to do with me. I don't know who the Myrmidons are. And I don't know what Free the Soul is, and I certainly don't know anything about some old fart called Brother.
Oh, Dio, tell me, how's that foot taste? Who the Myrmidons are? I don't recall saying the Myrmidons were people. And what about Brother? How would you know his age if I hadn't said anything besides his name?
He's left, but that means he's a terrorist.
A terrorist?
Oh, terrorists.
Left?
he's gonna show his bomb switch, isn't he?
Well, looks like I won't be able to talk my way out of this one. Seriously, though, when did we get so famous? The Myrmidons aren't supposed to be something anybody knows about.
So far, this is very similar to the Sigma ending.
Yeah.
Okay. You got me. Yes, I'm the leader of the Myrmidons. My real name is Left. I was sent here to stop Zero Senior's AB plan. That's why I planted the bombs. If it looked like the plan might actually succeed, I was supposed to blow this whole place sky high.
AB plan?
What's that?
Oh, well, Looks like you don't know everything after all. I should have been more careful. Then again, it's not like it really matters. After all, you're gonna die here.
What?
God damn it. No. I leapt toward him.
Well, there. Better not come any closer. You think I'm not prepared for this? Take one step and it'll be your last.
Then, that thing you're holding.
It's the detonator.
Yeah, I guess it is. Now back the fuck off!
Dio, please, calm down! If you press that button, you'll die too!
So? Believe me, there's plenty more where this came from.
What?
Now that we've cleared that up, back off! Come on, move it! Go, go, go!
We had no choice. Slowly, carefully, we backed away. All of us, except for one. Tenmyoji.
Hey, Grandpa. Your hearing gone? I said back off.
No.
You. I'm not screwing around here.
I can see that. So why don't you do it?
Go ahead. Press that button.
What?
Tenmyoji?
Is something wrong? Hurry it up. I'm not getting any younger. Oh, do I sense hesitation? What's the matter, Dio? Scared? Well?
You son of a bitch.
So you were just bluffing?
Not bluffing, goddammit. You hear me? I'll do it.
Oh, I'm sure you will. But there's really something I should tell you. See that detonator you're holding? It's a fake.
What?
For just an instant, Dio's eyes twitched down to a device in his hand. That was all the opening Tenmyoji needed.
Yeah!
He cried out as he leapt through the air. Tenmyoji's leg shot out, knocking the detonator from Dio's hand. Shit! Not good.
What happened?
The detonator. He doesn't have it anymore.
What? What's happening?
30 minutes.
There's a red light on it now.
Oh, you really fucked up, Tenmyoji. This is what happens when you try to show off.
What?
I'm sorry. This is my fault. I didn't have time to tell you how it worked.
What are you saying?
The detonator isn't supposed to be separated from Dio. If it is, then the timer on the bombs automatically activates.
Damn, how much do you know? Fine, whatever. Well, he's right. If that thing ever gets more than a meter away from me, it activates. When it does, it starts the timers on all the bombs. So thanks to this old fart, you get to try and defuse a bunch of activated bombs on a countdown. You can go ahead and destroy the detonator if you want. Once the timers have been activated, they'll go off anyway.
How long do we have? When do they explode?
You should know, Sigma. Why don't you tell her?
30 minutes.
30 minutes? That's crazy!
Yeah.
How do we stop them?
The emergency deactivation password.
None of us know them, though.
Right. None of us know. But there's someone who does, isn't there?
What, hoping I might spill the beans? Nice try. Unless one of you is secretly a medium, I think you're shit out of luck.
Hey, what the hell?
Go. Yeah.
That's oddly specific.
Wait, a medium?
Well, I'm out. Peace.
Wait. Stop! I threw myself towards Dio and wrapped my hand around his wrist, slamming it to the floor. He struggled, but I put all my weight on it and kept his arm pinned.
Shit! Let go of me, goddammit! Get off of me! Let me go!
He continued to struggle, but I wasn't going to let him go. I shifted my weight to free one of my hands and started trying to pry his open.
Hey! Hey! I'm not fucking around, alright? Let go of my goddamn arm!
By then, the others had run over and piled onto Dio along with me. Even then, he refused to stop. With increasing desperation, he tried to get the hand I had grabbed to his mouth.
We don't have a choice. Luna, Go get the soaparil.
Yeah, he's killed himself several times.
Now, if we put him to sleep, we can't get what we need out of him.
You think I don't know that? What other choice do we have? Every minute we spend wrestling this prick is a minute we don't have to deal with those bombs. We don't have time for this.
Shit.
What are you doing, Luna? Go! Right. Okay, I've got it. I'm ready when you are.
You can do whatever you want to me, you fucking cowards! You're still gonna die! Go ahead, tell yourselves you can fix it. Run around like idiots before you get blown to atoms. Serves you fucking right! You're gonna burn!
Oh, for God's sake! Luna, shut him up! Right, here goes.
As they began to climb off of him, I finally pried Dio's hand open. There it was, just what I'd expected. A small, unassuming capsule. I didn't know what was in it exactly, but it was undoubtedly some kind of poison. I stumbled toward the sink and tossed it into the drain. How much time do we have left?
25 minutes or so, I believe.
And how much time until the white doors open?
The same.
So, what do we do?
We put in the password and stop the bombs.
We search Dio, but he doesn't have a note or anything with the codes on it.
Well, only one option left then.
Yeah, and that is?
Intuition. We trust our hunches.
That's... are you suggesting we just... guess?
Do you have a better idea?
Well, no, but...
wait. There's another way. What is it? Before I can tell you, everyone has to promise to do exactly as I say. No questions. What's your answer?
We all nodded.
Good. First of all, Sigma, you're coming with me.
Right.
The rest of you, listen up. I want you to take Alice, Quark, and Dio to the Floor B warehouse. Huh?
Why?
Didn't I say no questions? Good. That's it. We're done.
That's... it?
Is there a problem? I seem to recall you promised to do exactly what I told you to do. Okay, we don't have much time left. Now get moving. Sigma, you're with me.
Bai turned without waiting and headed for the door. Before I could blink, she was gone. I gave everyone else in the infirmary a quick thumbs up and a shaky smile. Take care of these guys, okay? We'll see you back on Floor B before you know it. So, just trust us, alright? Good? I couldn't think of anything else to say. I turned and ran after Fi.
Just
oh
trust
shit,
us.
My camera's frozen or something.
Oh, yeah, your camera is frozen. I think this is the route where we betrayed at the very beginning. Like, is the route where we betrayed Alice? If I remember right.
I don't know.
No, this could be new. I don't know what I mean by betraying.
No, I'm just like, I'm riffing on the fact that he said, just trust us, okay?
Oh, you mean the bear, can you?
Yeah. Alright, so I think we know where three of the bombs are, but there's still a missing zero bomb. We don't know where that is.
I'm in the location.
I might have the codes for you.
Okay. So what do we do?
Get the input device ready.
Alright, done.
Hey, Flipper.
All hooked up and everything.
How many minutes do we have left?
Well, they'll go off when the doors open, so... 21 minutes.
That means we have 7 minutes per bomb. That includes travel time, though.
Bomb number 2 is in the control room of Floor B. And bomb number one is also on floor B with the garden. So, we just need to hurry, right?
Yeah.
So what are we supposed to do? I mean, you do have some sort of plan, right?
Well, it's not like I don't have one.
She's a concept of a plan.
So mysterious. God damn it. Tell me. Well, show's over, folks. What the hell am I supposed to do?
You need to make a jump.
Jump?
Yeah, to another world. Another history.
Oh, so are there locks for, like, each bomb password?
There's probably a lock for each.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is probably the
you
most locked.
You didn't just guess that Dio set the bombs, did you? You knew it. Because you remembered it happening in another history, didn't you?
Yeah, I did, but that's... I mean...
You just have to do that again.
Yeah, four times or so. So you're saying I need to go to another history and get the password out of Dio somehow?
Doesn't have to be another one. It could be this one. Just go back to the past and question him. Then again, if you do that, you might end up changing things so you don't end up here. That would mean you couldn't deactivate the bombs in this history. So you have to come back to this exact moment, or...
Damn it! This is so confusing!
Well, don't think about it then. We don't have time anyway. Just jump!
Okay, okay. I get it. See you later then. Are you insane? You're talking about transporting myself across space and time. Also, why should I have to do everything? Can't you jump too?
My jumps happen suddenly, out of the blue. I can't control them.
Okay. There's only been a few timelines where she's been, like, very, like, assertive.
Do you
the
think...
The Dio ending was the most significant one.
Do you guys think that we've had routes where we've experienced two different Phis?
One time in the Dio's ending.
Well, yeah, Dio's ending for sure.
Yeah.
Like, that's where she was like, I need the number zero bomb, which I presume is going to happen at the end of this one. Because we know of three bombs, and we're assuming there's only three right now.
Mm-hmm.
But she was like, what's the passcode for the number zero bomb? So that would be the Phi that we're experiencing right now. We encountered at the ending, at Dio's ending.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess
this
that makes
fun.
Sense. Yeah. Phi's so interesting.
Well, it's just fun to have, like, another character that's, like, taking it back, you see the timeline. She's also... technically jumping between timelines too.
I want you guys to play Gnosis.
Why so feisty?
Neither can I.
No,
that's
sir.
A problem. All right, consider this. Maybe we've already jumped from another history to this one, but our memories of that history got damaged or something. We forgot most of what happened in that other timeline. If we can remember even a little bit, though. Anyway, it's just a hypothesis.
Are you saying I might know it already? And I just have to try and remember it?
Yeah. I feel like we know. So? Anything? We need the bomb password. Do you remember hearing it in another timeline?
I stared down at the input device. Password. Password. The bomb password. Actually, I did remember it. I had heard it.
Do I just say these or type them in? They're not very long. I'll say them.
Yeah, I think it would be more fun TV if you said them.
All right, bomb three. LXQL. HCN. MR.
Good job. It worked.
I sighed and wiped what felt like a bucket's worth of sweat from my forehead.
So you knew the password after all. Interesting.
Yeah, I guess I did.
Inverted in another history? Just what happened in that other timeline? never mind. We don't have time for that. How much longer?
Dio's face. 18 minutes.
Good. We've still got time. Come on, let's go. We've still got two more. The number two bomb is next on the list.
So we're heading to a control room?
No time to waste. Oh, and don't forget the input device.
And then she was gone. I hurriedly disconnected the device from the bomb and chased after her.
I presume we're gonna encounter it, I presume, as we make it to the white doors. My guess.
I mean, logically, I think there would be two bombs downstairs and two bombs upstairs.
We gotta rush back up the stairs.
That's what I think it's gonna be.
You got it?
Yeah, right here.
Hook it up.
Great. Done.
Okay. Hurry it up. Plug in the password.
Done. Oh, is he just doing it? Oh, no. Hey! What the hell?
Calm down. You probably just typed it in wrong.
No way. I'm sure I did it right.
Try it again.
Yeah, nothing. That password's no good.
Then it's different. All three bombs use different passwords.
Okay.
Yeah, looks like it.
Shit!
Bai slammed her foot against the locker, her face uncharacteristically twisted by anger and frustration.
This is bad. What the hell are we gonna do? Try and remember it. Did you see or hear anything in another history that could be a password? A different password.
You mean like a different history from the other one I remember?
Yeah, you figured it out there. You just can't remember it very well right now. Remember what happened with the last bomb? This one is just like that.
Another history. The password. Do I know what it is? Can I remember it? I have to.
I'm beginning to think, I think I know where everything's leading now. All right, password bomb two?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
All right, it is EQDDYRNTK.
I'm glad you got your new microphone. This is so clear and nice.
Like when we talked to Zero, he was talking about the termites.
Mm.
So you did know it.
Yeah, guess so.
Don't scare me like that, all right?
Come on, it's not like I was hiding it. I just couldn't remember it at first. Then it just kind of floated up. Maybe it drifted
Whatever.
Down.
The point is, we disarmed the thing. Amazing.
You know, the director David Lynch describes getting ideas as catching fish.
What?
Mm-hmm. You sure don't sound very amazed.
Okay. That just leaves us with the last bomb. It's
in the garden.
Right. Let's go take care of it while you're on a roll with these things.
Gah. Or what's my best Cali impression?
Gah.
Yep.
You make it sound so easy.
Well, don't just stand there. Let's go.
So
she spun around and was gone. I gripped the input device tightly and headed off after her.
So, yeah, with what just Fly was just saying right there, we are clearly linking every timeline right now to this one.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy.
I just remembered something. There was like a gravestone that we couldn't like do anything with here, right? Or did we do it with Luna?
No.
But yeah, there was like
we never interacted with.
Yeah.
Finally, the last one.
Yeah, totally.
How many minutes left?
Less than 10.
It's okay. We can still make it. Just stay calm, all right? You have the input device?
Yeah. There we go. Connected.
Okay. Go.
Go?
We've done this twice already. Do you really need a third pep talk?
You want me to remember another password, right?
Exactly. What else would I be talking about?
What?
Don't sweat it. You did great the last two times. I'm sure this one will be a cakewalk. Your time's the charm, right?
That's, not really how that's used. I'm just worried that lightning's not going to strike twice or thrice in this case, I guess.
No, I think mine still works. There's nothing to suggest the first and second times aren't charmed, too.
I guess so.
Whatever. Just do it. You're the only person who can.
What about you? You can jump to other worlds, too, right?
Yeah, but I can't remember things as well as you, all right? I'm doing the best I can, but either I haven't seen the stuff you have, or I just can't remember it. Maybe we've been going to different worlds. Anyway.
Well, I like the idea that maybe there's like, I don't know, 30, I mean, there's infinite worlds, right?
There might be timelines she's seen that we haven't.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'll give it a shot.
I'm counting on you.
The password. Remember, Sigma. Come on. Lightning can strike twice, or even three times. You can do it. You did it before. You did it twice before. This is nothing. You're a champion. Come on, Sigma. You can do this. Pull open the door to your memories.
And lightning returns.
I was getting Kingdom Hearts from that, but either way, we both thought Square Enix.
Right? Oh, the root beer float right there.
In the previous one, I saw the. What is going on with my camera? What the fuck?
You're so serious. You're so serious all this time. That's what camera's like.
Update.
Yeah, camera's like, oh, Kevin is serious, so he's not making a lot of facial change.
So this password we actually got from Zero himself, from his recording, he told us, which is interesting. All right, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, it is BQZ RGJ DXR.
Yeah! Suck on that, Dio, you arrogant son of a bitch. Ah, that feels good. I haven't felt this satisfied in ages. It's like my whole brain is just swimming in endorphins. I feel like it's just going to melt and dribble out of my ears.
He's fucking high.
Yeah, he's experiencing like a eureka moment. This is, without a doubt, what heaven feels like. Honestly, I feel like I could fly right now. Hell, I almost wish there was another Hell, I almost wish there was another bomb so I could feel this again. Isn't this great? Bye. Fi's like, hold on, I'm getting something. Hey, what's going on? You're really harshing the vibe here. Would it really kill you to smile? We just saved everybody. Oh, also, not that I need it or anything, but it sure would be nice to get a thank you or something. Oh, thank you, Sigma. You're the greatest. You're so awesome. I'll dress up in this swimsuit for you, just like I promised. Hey, that was a different timeline too, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, just a swimsuit thing would be fine, really, but... Are you even listening to me?
I am. You said you wished there was another bomb, right?
Well, I mean, I don't really...
I hope you're happy. You're going to get your wish.
What?
I remembered something, too. Just a glimpse. We must have confronted Dio about the bombs. I'm not sure how, but we got him to tell us about them.
Exactly. I've planted four bombs.
Ah.
They're the ones numbered 1, 2, and 3. But there's also one more. Bomb number 0.
We did learn that.
I felt a cold shiver run down my spine. Suddenly, I remembered it too. I'd heard Dio say those very words in the 4B warehouse. No. No way.
Looks like you remember it too.
Yeah.
How much time do we have?
Yeah, right, where the fuck is this bomb?
We've only got 4 minutes.
Well, hurry up. We need to get to the 0 bomb.
Right. I yanked the input device out of the bomb and turned the chase after. What are you just standing there for? Go, show me where the bomb is.
What? Are you telling me you don't know where it is? You have got to be kidding me.
How the hell would I know where the bomb is? Oh shit, you don't know. She bit her lip and nodded. Damn it. What the hell are we supposed to do now? We can't deactivate the bomb if we don't know where the damn thing is.
Calm down, just calm down. You need to think, Sigma. There has to be a clue somewhere. Pretend you're Dio. You need to hide the bomb. Where would you hide something important?
Hide something important.
Right.
Hide. Hide. If I was Dio, where would I hide? Ah!
Sigma,
wait! Where are you going?
Don't follow me. Go find the others.
Idiot! Do you really think I'd do that?
I could hear her following me, but there was no time to argue. Instead, I focused on my goal. There was still time.
I don't know where we're going. Do you?
No.
Are you going up?
Is it the where we're going?
You called it.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense to have 2 on each floor if you have 4 bombs.
Is it where?
Yeah, I don't know where specifically he's going. Oh, is he put? Did he put a bomb like in his elevator?
I'll split. Where everybody? Yes.
Where he like dropped in and killed Akane?
Oh, it's right. Okay.
Here.
It's right there.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we see it. Oh, we're gonna have to fucking move the rooms with the crane.
Yeah,
it should be between these AB rooms. Some days you just can't get rid of a bomb. Open the 10th lock in VLR. Good, I was right. How much time do we have left?
About a minute.
Okay.
Shit.
Hurry!
I'm hurrying as fast as I can. Sorry, that's all I can think of when I see shit with like that many eyes.
Yeah.
Shit. The input device was plugged in. I was ready to go. Now I just had to enter the password. What was the password? I couldn't shake the feeling that I'd already used up my 3rd time charm. Still, I had to try. I shook my head and concentrated. Vi knows the password.
Yeah, but she told us to make sure we remember, because she can't remember as well as us.
Oh, okay. All right.
Garrett. All right, number 0 password. LXA QN SGDQ.
Oh, yeah.
Notice Q was used in a lot of these passwords multiple times. Every password had Q in it.
What could it mean? It stopped.
Yeah.
Fine, I crumpled to the ground. They still have to get to the fucking door.
Yeah, they gotta book it.
Yeah, the adrenaline that had sustained us suddenly gone.
How did you know it was here? Did you see it in another history?
It's hard to explain. The short version is that Dio hid something here in another timeline. Yeah. I guess maybe you put the bomb here too.
Pretty good guess.
Yeah.
Well, you did it. So, thanks.
Oh, I don't need any thanks. Just
what?
About that swimsuit you promised.
What? What on earth are you talking about?
Chromatic doors have opened. 5 minutes remain until chromatic doors close.
Okay, we got 5 minutes to book it.
This is bad.
It's just funny because Sigma, at least mentally, is like the same age as Phi, but physically, I guess he's like, what, like in his 50s or 60s?
Oh, you know what they say, age is just a number.
Yeah. But I mean, it hits differently when you get told like about that swimsuit from like an old man.
The white doors have opened. We need to hurry. Everyone else is waiting for us in the floor B warehouse.
What about the swimsuit?
What the hell are you going on about? Just go!
Before I could protest, she turned and ran toward the magenta door, sighed, and headed off after her. I hope we get the swimsuit in Zero Time Dilemma, which she's in. I ran into a warehouse to find everyone else already there. They'd done as Phi asked, and brought the 3 unconscious members of our party back to the doors. So that's Dio, Quark, and Alice?
Yes.
Yeah, I guess if Alice was awake, she would have like lunged on Dio first.
No, not only that, but... Yeah, right. I think
we cloned the cure and gave it to both Alice and Quark in this.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's like... Everything that we've like learned across all the timelines is coming into play here.
Let me look at this. That's funny because there hasn't been like that many locks.
But there's also been a few novel locks.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, like these are kind of locks.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Phi and I shared a quick glance, then headed over toward them.
Oh, thank goodness. I'm so glad you're safe.
So, did you disable the bombs?
Yeah. I could have done it in my sheep.
Don't you mean in your sleep?
They reversed their bit.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good job, you guys.
No need to thank me. Although, I mean, if you insist, I wouldn't mind a little swimsuit time.
What?
Huh? You're disgusting.
Voice.
1 minute remains until all right. Chromatic
who's
doors
our group?
Close.
We need to hurry.
Everybody know who's in their group?
No.
Yeah, I'm set.
Alright. Let's move.
At least he knows.
Yeah. Yeah, it's my diary. Of course I know the code. At 10 Miyoji's command, we broke off into our teams. Kay carried Quark on his back and dragged Dio along the floor and through the white door.
Oh, poor Kay.
Dio, don't get a break.
Clover and Luna carried Alice through the door on the right. And Tamyoji, Fi, and myself ran through the center door. Yeah, protagonist party.
This is the protagonist party, yeah.
10 seconds remain until chromatic doors close. 9, 8, 7.
Always to the last second.
5, 4.
Gotta have countdowns. 3,
wonder what hell puzzle room we're gonna have
1,
here.
0.
Yeah, I'm wondering if we've seen this room in another route. I'm trying to remember. No?
We have not. This is the third time we're finally making it through the white chromatic doors. This is the last puzzle. Jihun was right, none of them repeat.
But yeah, I was just wondering if we like saw it, but like not, you know,
no,
run through the puzzle. Q
room.
Hey, Q room. Huh.
Hey there, John.
Oh shit.
My eyes.
What the hell? There's nothing here.
Well, there are doors. The one we came in. And that one, which I'm assuming is the exit.
Can't punch it open.
Can't punch it open.
Won't budge.
The plaque on the door just said Q.
I can't punch it open.
Q. What the hell's that supposed to mean?
Really? Now someone's just being a smartass.
Huh?
Nothing. Maybe the Q is for question.
Well, I guess it is a very questionable room.
If there was a deck of cards here, maybe the Q would be for queen.
That's a quality guess right there.
Right. Well, we need to get out of here. Let's find a way to get the door open.
We also need to find the star keys. I've got enough BP to open the door, but you guys need to play the AB game some more.
Yeah.
We still need a few more points.
If we can get those star keys, we should be able to play the AB game as many times as we need to. So...
it's just a matter of time until we get the points we need.
Right.
Well, let's get started then.
Good.
Okay.
Seek a way out! Okay. What are we supposed to do here? The room's empty. Wait, do you hear something? Whoa! We're in like a fighting game training room now. Huh. Well, how much you want to bet it has something to do with that? So we should go have a look. I think this cube is just floating here. Well, you touch it and see if anything happens. Oh fuck, we're Minesweeper! So wait, is the goal to hit a mine?
No, because they're all hitting something.
It's all the bottom corner there.
Yeah, it's a 3-3-3 bottom.
Yeah, 3-3-2. 2-3-3-2 there at the bottom.
I don't understand what's going on here. Have another look at it. The cube. Look at it again. There are winning and losing panels on the wall. The cube can help you find the winning panels. When the winning panels, and only the winning panels, are highlighted in cyan, the system will activate. Here's how you find the winning panels. When you select a panel on the cube, it will display a number. Each surrounding panel will also display a number. This number indicates the number of winning panels that border each panel.
Okay. Oh, we do want the high numbers.
Oh, okay.
Oh my god, it's getting overly complicated.
Mm-hmm.
Our total eight just... puzzles. alright, well anyway. Yeah, those...
So that tells us... that, right?
Yeah.
What about with the twos?
Oh, do I want everything that has a number?
No, I think you just want the threes. That was my understanding.
Well, is it going to tell us that we... try it with the twos as well. So it'd be those four on the far left.
Right?
Maybe something like that.
I think it's just the four. Like the, how should I describe this? Column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Column 1.
You get what I mean when I say that?
Yeah, yeah. Column 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep.
Yeah, get rid of the 2 on the side of it.
Okay.
Oh!
Yeah, because it was just the 3, or the 2, 3, 3, 2.
Whoa, what the hell?
Okay, so it's in okay, I get what's going on here, sort of. The way we view the cube, and then...
We have to get out of the... Because we're still stuck on the... Yeah.
Yeah, so let's turn around and do each wall.
Uh-huh.
Alright, see what's going on. This would be east-facing wall, then, if the other one was the north-facing wall.
So...
Yeah, so okay, so it's only... Yeah, exactly. So it's only what's at... Whoop, what's adjacent?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Directly, not diagonally, but like...
You see that? So it's like 111, the middle one, and then over here on that one bit, it's the two, the three, the two, and then the three to two, but not...
Oh, it's all,
this
you
is
almost like a minesweeper.
Okay.
No, you
okay.
Just almost like a minesweeper.
Yeah. Also, if we struggle, I have the, I have the answers.
So there are four in that corner.
Man, we must need grid paper to do this. So that would be... Hold up. So I think the six in the bottom there. It's like 4, 4, 3, 3.
Can we go back to the puzzle? Like,
oh man, how lost are you? Oh, okay, good. Yeah, we can do it that way. What's nice though is like the moment you get it, it's like you did it, you know? So we know where all the big numbers are. They're all in the bottom.
What?
So we're only highlighting stuff on the bottom.
I don't know if it's 4, yeah. You know what? Light them all. Light them all. Oh.
It's not that high, dude.
Yeah, it's just bottom.
Let me know if you just want the answers. I know you're just like blindly clicking things at this point.
Let's wait 4 for sure.
What's funny is I think like your camera isn't frozen right now, but if it was, we wouldn't be able to tell.
Oh yeah.
I think it's a straight. Yeah, it's a 4. No, dude, I think it's a straight line. Ah, oh, damn it.
No.
That had a number.
It shouldn't be more than the first two, like the bottom two rows.
Can we check the cube?
that it's not those ones.
Cool.
It's gonna be the fours and threes. So it's just those the bottom six, like those. It's like a block of six there, not the far right. Oh shit!
Oh god!
Oh, oh man, wait. Pulling every like puzzle thing throughout the game.
Yeah,
let's bring all everything first. Yeah, you can't do it from that mode. Let's. Oh Jesus! Don't do that.
Well, we don't know what to do with that yet. Okay. And what's...
It's every puzzle in the game. We're linking every puzzle right now.
So, time to
like what I said before, we're linking every timeline. So, yeah, that should be it for that one. So now we're going to look at the south wall.
So this two.
Yeah.
The left bottom.
So are you understanding the logic?
More or less. I'm trying to figure it. Like, don't love
so,
this.
So the two, like, it's only what's adjacent to the biggest number. So yeah, there you go. There should be one more.
Okay, I just didn't click the right. Okay, so I'm here.
One and okay, so it should just be one block, maybe two.
Yeah.
All right, so that should be it for that wall.
Yeah.
And then we got this would be the west wall, left.
Yeah, we haven't done from this angle. So.
All right, so two.
Yeah, two in the bottom left.
So it should only be at the bottom left, and then any more.
Oh.
And then
three on the
check
right.
The hole, check that wall. So 3, 3, 2 should just be those three then. Oh, it kind of makes it easy because of what's already revealed, actually.
Uh-huh.
It can only be the three on the right.
Ah.
Okay, we've done everything now, right?
At least that's what
we
did.
Yes, we revealed everything. Oh man, there's... Jesus. I'm just going through the spoiler-free guy. There's a lot to do here.
Fi is convinced that these are Sidewinder missiles.
Alright, so we'll put the dartboard.
There's no score that we have to.
Are we just fucking vibing?
Let's see what it tells you when you activate it.
That's a dartboard. Let's just try it out.
Sorry?
Oh, get a score of 100. First dart must land in green. Second one must be blue.
Oh, so it's just like a
scoreboard,
yeah.
Okay.
And
okay, so
goes,
get green, blue, red, get 100. Oh, okay.
Are they applying the whole triple digit thing too? Like if you put it to the closest, it's a triple digit?
It would have to be. Alright, I think it's best to work backward, like work from the triple to the double to the single.
Yeah, but the first one has to be green.
Yeah.
So a triple green, there's only three options, a 13, a 14, and a 9. So you would get 39, you'd get 27, 42. So I'd go with like a middling number between 42, 39, and 27. I'd go for one of the, because if we're going trying to add up to 100, we want like in the 30s more or less, right?
100 is big number, so
we have a pencil.
Yeah.
Is 33, 33, 34, 50, 100. So that's 42. Now we got blue.
Okay,
for blues, triples are 16, 24. If it's okay. So you need 30 to win. Can you win with red on a 30? It would need to be, there's no 10, so you can't. All right, so that's 39 for blues. That's 22. Are you?
Is Kevin seriously throwing random?
I'm seriously bad at math, so
we're trying to figure it out for you, and you're just trying.
I think the 39 is a good start.
Yeah.
With the green, that's the 13. So for blue, triples are 24. The double options are 28, 22, and 18. So I'd go for, I mean, our best. Our highest things we can get are 20s, so 24. Now we need to get a 27, is it? Or a 37. Is a 37 possible on a red? We have...
I mean, that's not possible
highest,
number.
No, the highest you can get is a 33 on the red. So working back, we need... we need 4 more points. So we need a 28 on the blue. 28 on a blue. Yeah, green 13, 22 on a blue is 11. And then what you put for the red, the 33. That's also on the 11. Not 33. 9. 14, 28. Then the 33. What does this give us, a memory card?
Yeah. Green.
Right, yeah. So that's one puzzle room down. Piece of cake.
Three chuckle fucks try to do math. This was the light puzzle. That was in... Looks like we have to turn them all red.
Luna timeline. That was actually one of the white rooms.
I'm guessing we have to turn all the pieces red.
Yeah, but careful with that green corner. Oh, okay.
Alright, so this is just lights out.
Oh, I only have so many moves. Okay.
The pattern we're trying to make?
I think it's all red.
It's all red, yeah.
Oh, all red. And I wasn't counting how many moves we had there.
I think it's 5. Yeah, just working it out.
Yeah, we just gotta, like, slowly push everything into one corner, and then lights out. I think trying to move them all to the top might be best. If we can get it all the way to just those two top triangles getting green and then hit the top, lights out. Because how many moves? Five moves? No. What if we start with those two bottom triangles?
Which ones do you mean?
The one right next to your cursor, that one. And then like the other one. Okay, and then hit the two circles in the center. And then hit the top.
Holy shit. Damn. Andrew got it. Damn.
I actually used to have a little portable lights out thing that I played with as a kid.
Okay. Wow. I didn't know that was a thing.
All right, so we got tablet.
Binder.
And...
Look, woman.
Oh.
Q chamber special AB game. Oh shit. Yeah, I'm gonna not read that for a while. Oh, this is these say AB on it. Okay, so I guess it's like after we get all the cards, we play an AB game. Alright, so we got these fucking dice. Can't put it off any longer. Roll the six dice to move them to where they need to go. The direction of each side of each die must... Okay.
I think, are we still missing something here? Then we need to look around.
Or check that die thing. Maybe the paper we picked up.
Like for the AB game?
Mm-hmm.
There it is.
No, it's not that shit.
Is there anything else in the room?
Oh.
Oh yeah, there's this. I think I've seen something like this before.
That's meowing at me.
Aww. It's a hologram generator.
That was where Zero appeared.
What about the... Maybe we should start playing the metal card. The machine, maybe.
It's red card, huh? This green card, huh?
Hey. Cat's jumping around. Did we reveal everything on that wall? Is there one more? Everything was on the bottom.
Yeah. Four blocks.
How high did we press? Maybe we need to press one more on the left side? It doesn't go that far. It doesn't go past the third row, I don't think.
Nope. Oh, shelf.
Jesus. Oh, nice. And we gotta get out of this mode.
Mm-hmm.
There, okay.
Mm-hmm. There are some pictures put in between the pages back here. Three of them, it looks like. Okay.
Okay.
Picture of blue dice.
Ah, their orientations.
This is going to suck.
So on a 3D, so column
the red one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's eight. I was going to say there's eight columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 rows. So that would be, if I'm going column row, 4, 3. I'm just trying to place them. I can write this out. Hold on. All right, so for blue, I'm going to make the grid here. 1, 2, 6, 7. So we have, that would be column 7, or row 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, that's blue 1, and then 1, 2, 3, blue 5, okay, I got that. I'll point out where everything goes. I made a little grid.
Okay.
So green, that goes from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's green 6, and then 1 to the left, 1, 2, that's green 2, okay, and I think the reds are just going to slot into this. This is going to make just like a little pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, it does. So that's red 4, and then there's a red 3. Okay.
So I'm guessing the really diabolical part is I'm going to have to like rotate and move each die to get into this pattern.
Here, here's what I'm going to do right quick for you.
Okay.
I'm going to take a picture of what I just drew, and I'm going to throw that in the thing.
Oh, this is... Okay. I'm going to throw it up on the stream.
So you see exactly where... Oh, hell yeah, sure. I'm going to put it in the stream chat. And you'll know exactly where all that shit goes. Come on. Discord, cooperate. Here's the thing. Here's my handwriting. But that should show you exactly where they go. You want to pull up my drawing?
I'm working on it.
What's funny is, so like at work we were doing some kind of anonymous kind of like letter thing. It's like you get assigned to a random coworker, and it's like, all right, write nice things, or like things that come to mind. And the person that I got, I was like, oh, I actually have lots of nice things to say about her. And my handwriting, I think, is like very identifiable, so even though it's anonymous, she'll probably instantly know that it was me.
Okay, right here looks like a good spot. All right.
Yep. Line them up. Starting from column 4, row 3.
Yes, so this is going to be fucking diabolical.
Oh, fuck. Right, we got to do that shit.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
All right, have fun with that. Are you going to work your way down? Or are you starting from the bottom? Alright, so while Kevin does that,
I'll be here a while, boys.
Yeah,
chat
I've
away.
Been playing, like, I've been playing fuck all. Like, I've been busy at work again. I get home, I don't really want to do anything. I've been pretty active in the Pokemon Go. Because I think I mentioned in the last stream, they had just finally brought Dynamax to the game. That was the mechanic that they added with Sword Shield, which... I don't know Kevin's opinion on that. That was the premiere of quote-unquote Dexit, where it's like, oh, we're not going to have the full every Pokemon anymore in games. And so that was like, a lot of people were upset about that. Dynamax as a mechanic in the games was like kind of a combination of the previous two gimmicks Megas and Z Crystals, where it's like, instead of just one really powerful move, you get three, and everyone gets this bonus, but it doesn't last very long. I thought it was like a kind of buff on Z moves, a debuff on Mega, but everybody gets to access it.
Megas was so good.
It was, but I almost feel like they should have been their own evolutions, because if they don't have the gimmick, like, in the generation, like Mawile, for instance, just kind of sucks. Like, it doesn't really have, like, I guess it has Intimidate, so it can kind of be like a support, but...
They should just be evolutions.
Mega Evolve was fucking awesome. It was, like, total beast. I love her design with, like, the twin tail mounts.
Yes.
But, yeah, it's unfortunate. And also because of that, she, Mawile can pretty much never get an evolution.
Yeah.
Because it has the Mega. Though I say that, and then they did, so I was talking about Dynamaxes. They introduced Gigantamax, which mostly is just like an appearance difference. They're the max moves for the Gigantamaxes aren't very interesting, in my opinion. I don't know if you lined
it
up right.
Oh wait, I didn't. Yeah, you're right.
One row over for the top. But yeah, they added Dynamax Pokemon. It's like, I only just got into this game again, playing with Donna, and it's kind of interesting that I'm kind of on the ground floor of a whole new mechanic that requires you to get whole new Pokemon, so it's like, I may as well have started now in the game. And it's fun. I started with the OG trio. I got a pretty badass Charmander and a Squirtle, and then they got a Beldum. Is added right now, so I'm working on getting him and having a super awesome Metagross.
This
it's getting me to run around a lot.
Right?
Six, red, three, blue, one. What the fuck? Should have been. Did I fuck up? Yeah, starting from row four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. G2, R4, blue five. Green 6, red 3, blue 1. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is our orientation off for some reason? Is that supposed to be... Is the top supposed to be the left? No, that doesn't make any sense. The actual puzzle is turned about 45 degrees from this. If you hold your hand held slightly left, it will line up. What the fuck? It is. God damn it. Okay.
Okay, so...
Ah, shit. Yeah, so I put it on a grid to make it easier, but the actual puzzle is turned about 45 degrees from this. If you hold your hand held slightly left,
is it like this? The
grid. Slightly left. 45 degrees. Man, I'm having trouble now orienting this in my head.
Is it this? Like what I did on the... I just rotated the image. This sucks.
I guess.
Okay, let me rewire my brain here.
Yeah, so everything starting from... I don't know where you want to start.
Man.
Left or right, blue one. It's column two, one, two, three, four, five.
Well, let me just start over.
I'm sorry, I threw you off again. That's what it looked like to me.
Yeah.
From the thing.
Huh. Yeah, it looked that way, yeah.
Fuck you, guide. Thank you. Oh, actually, I got instructions you might like more.
Okay, okay. I'm guessing I'm starting fresh.
If we reset, this'll be quick.
Okay. Ready.
Post it to the stream chat.
Oh, okay. I'll get rid of that.
And that's all okay. From starting position. Man, that's annoying.
Thanks, Jihun, for the jump scare.
You have to describe our anguish one or another.
Alright, so that gets us all the AB. Oh, you know what? What was the, we had a thing about an AB game.
Yeah. That's, yeah. That's for the, screen.
Let's review that again. So check our archive.
Yeah.
Okay. Three will definitely just ally you.
So our first answer, we have to get to 9, and then second answer is we must be the only one to surpass 9.
So this is the answer for green screen and blue screen.
We want to test it. We want to see who's picking what.
Yeah, this seems like it's just like Alright, well let's look at this, I guess.
Okay, so you're just gonna line it up. Let's shut this down.
Alright, and we push one.
Yep. So if we pick ally, let's see who picks what.
The C is a mirror man.
Whoa, what happened? It just went...
It just added the,
I didn't get to see what the hell happened.
But, C is a mirror man. C always copies other person.
So C is mirror man. So I gotta figure out A, B, D, and E.
A betray. B betray. Yeah, I think B was also actually B was.
Okay, so if we wanna salvage this.
Was it D ally or betray?
Looks like we have 3 games. It ends on game 3.
Well, we should be able to get the only we leave thing pretty easily, I think.
Right now? So. So if we choose betray. He chooses betray, so you want the. B as a boy for you. Oh, this paradox. Fuck.
Or we're still trying to figure this out, right?
Yeah.
Well, we might just be able to do this. Hold on, I'm thinking.
I think the parasolo thing matters. That doesn't mean shit. All we're trying to do is like see who always picks what. We know that C is always mirroring. A betrayed. A always betrayed.
Okay.
So A betrayed every time. Why he betray me? All right, so we gotta figure out B, D, and E, right? Or did you figure any of those out, Jihun?
I missed D as well. Oh, yeah.
All right, well, A always betrays. C always mirrors.
Yeah. B is ally.
B is always
B
ally?
B as on board, yeah.
B allied, D allied, E betrayed.
Yeah.
So, okay, so then A is betray, B is ally, C is mirror, D is ally, E is betray.
Yep.
So with that information, we have three games that make it so everyone hits 9, right?
Uh-huh.
And then a game where only we hit 9.
Is it going to be the green password and the blue password shit? I bet everyone 9 is probably the green.
I don't think A can come back.
I fucked up.
Yeah, we got to get it down to... by the final round. Let's
see. So for betray people, you... not a betray means 0, so you have to put the... Somebody has to be sacrificed, huh?
Wait, what's our objective? Is it everyone 9?
Yeah.
One. Okay, so we have two objectives. One is everyone 9, and the other is only we escape.
Now, does it... I wonder, like, if the everyone 9 thing, does it have to be exactly 9, or can it go over 9?
Okay, well, we should be able to do this pretty easily. Oh, never mind. Hang on.
Double check the art.
Okay, so the other two solos... Okay, so C mirrors and the other two always betray.
Yeah, C mirrors, A,
the ally.
A and E betray.
Yeah.
I just want to double check on the instructions one more time. Six cooperators. Only six of them have to hit 9. So six people have to reach 9.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, because the
right,
two of them will be
fucking pairs. Okay.
So we can pair with any ally and just hit ally every time. That'll be 2.
And then A and E can be... Yeah, A and E.
Well, actually, since we have a mirror, set the mirror up with someone else. Well, let's see what happens. There's probably multiple solutions to this.
Possibly.
Yeah.
Yeah, 3.
That's 6.
Right, so that should be 6, yep.
Yeah, because 2 pairs and then 2 solos. Alright, we got the green password. Alright, so with the same information now, only us escape. No one else get over 9.
But we choose betray.
We want to, like, knock down people with betray. And make sure that other people don't,
So we can have either...
At all.
We can either have B or D for us. I'm sorry.
We can't have
D.
So it would have to be D. And then we just betray them over and over, right?
Yeah.
Yes. We might have to rotate the other people a little bit.
Okay.
So betray you. Why are you betraying me?
Do not put C and E against each other, because C is gonna copy.
I can't put C and E together.
No.
So we want to keep D. and maybe swap the bottom like we just did E and C, so yeah, C and E. And then just run it back to the first time.
Oh, we did it, right? Oh, yeah. Okay.
We have to get over 9, but no one else reached 9.
So E's gotta be, yeah, E, what does E do?
Yeah, throw A, B, yeah, throw those two back. We're keeping E's D. Just...
We can take E and betray them.
Yeah, then nobody gets it.
Well, no, we can't because we both betray. And then we don't get over 9. We have to get over 9. We need to betray every round.
Don't we just have to get 9?
No.
That's what I thought.
There's more than 9.
But there's, oh, let's okay. go with just 9. And let's see what happens.
So we want to keep D.
Oh.
Let's move him over somewhere.
Oh. Oh, oh, you made it.
All right, so then...
So these two betray, right?
Yes, and then B will always mirror, so they'll ally. And that'll be okay, because they won't exceed 9. Throw that down. Betray.
Okay.
Whew.
It worked out.
I was writing all that shit down again, too.
Okay, right. I think once we open the door, we or I guess once we're about to open the door or something, we call it for the first recording.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Blue password first. And based on that, well, I don't know. This might be the last puzzle.
Possible.
Last little bit of lore.
Oh, redacted. Found all the secrets in VLR.
There is no more puzzles then. Because you found all the secrets.
Or at least no more secrets.
No more puzzles or secrets.
And there's still a file we haven't gotten.
Oh,
kill yourself.
Okay, 2 bottles of fucking cure. Oh, okay, 2 star key cards. Whatever. Look at this. Oh, found all the files in VLR. A consummate collection.
There was a poison. I didn't know it was cure.
The Radical 6 cure. Thank goodness. Demiurge's crying.
Wait, did we not use cure, or do we just put them to sleep?
Oh, we may have just put them to sleep this time. Did we not do anything with that screen? We never did anything with it.
Oh, the hologram thing?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe. Oh, right. This,
it might activate when we leave. I don't know.
Yeah. That feels like it's going to be a story thing.
Oh.
Oh, man.
We found that after him.
All right. 3, 2, 1. 2, 3, stop that! Jeez, one more time. 3, 2, 1. Escapist escaped everything on hard difficulty. Yep. Okay. Okay, I say right here.
Sure, we'll pick up right here. We're at the 2-hour mark on the dot, more or less.
Yep. All right. Taking a break and some more water. We will be back with part 2 of our final stream for this game.
So long. See you soon.
Hydrate. Bye.